Flow control is managed by TCP using flow control feedback. So when you transfer the data from sender to receiver, data travels from the sending process down to the sending TCP, from the sending TCP to the receiving TCP, and from receiving TCP up to the receiving process. Flow control feedbacks, however, are traveling from the receiving TCP to the sending TCP and from the sending TCP up to the sending process. In other words, the receiving TCP controls the sending TCP. The sending TCP controls the sending process. Therefore, to achieve flow control, TCP forces the sender and the receiver to adjust their window sizes. So let's understand it in this video. Here we show how the send and receive windows are set during the connection establishment phase and how their situation will change during data transfer. To understand the flow control, we assume that data transfer is unidirectional from client to server without any error. To understand the flow control in better way, we will take 8 segments which are exchanged between the client and server. The first segment is from the client to server, which is a SYN segment to request connection. The client announces its initial sequence number, like 100. When this segment arrives at the server, it allocates a buffer size, like 800 bytes and sets its window to cover the whole buffer 800. The second segment is from the server to the client. This is an ACK plus SYN segment. The segment uses acknowledgement number 101 to show that it expects to receive bytes starting from 101 and sequence number 1000. It also announces that the client can set a buffer size of 800 bytes. The third segment is the ACK segment from the client to the server, and now connection is established. After the client has set its window with the size 800 dictated by the server, the process pushes 200 bytes of data. The TCP client numbers this byte 101 to 300. It then creates a segment and sends it to the server. The segment shows the starting byte number as 101 and the segment carries 200 bytes. The window of the client is then adjusted to show 200 bytes of data are sent, but waiting for acknowledgement. When this segment is received at the server, the bytes are stored and the receive window closes to show that the next byte expected is byte 301. The stored byte occupy 200 bytes of buffer. The fifth segment is the feedback from the server to the client. The server acknowledges bytes up to 300 and expecting to receive 301 as acknowledgement number. The segment also carries the size of the receive window after decrease to 600 bytes. The client, after receiving this segment, purges the acknowledged bytes from its window and closes its window to show that the next byte to send is byte 301. The window size, however, decreased to 600 bytes, although the allocated buffer can store 800 bytes. The window cannot open, it cannot move its write wall to the right because the receiver does not allow it. Segment 6 is sent by the client after its process pushes 300 more bytes. The segment defines sequence number as 301 and contains 300 bytes. When this segment arrives at the server stores them, but it has to reduce its window size. After its process has pulled 100 bytes of data, the window closes from left for the amount of 300 bytes, but opens from the right for the amount of 100 bytes. The result is that the size is only reduced 200 bytes, not 300 bytes. The receiver window size is now 400 bytes. In segment 7, the server acknowledges the receipt of data with acknowledgement number 601 and announces that its window size is 400. When this segment arrives at the client has no choice but to reduce its window again and set the window size to the value 400 as advertised by the server. The send window closes from the left by 300 bytes since data acknowledged and opens from the right by 100 bytes. Segment 8 may also from server after its process has pulled another 200 bytes. Its window size increases by 200. So, new receive window size value is now 600. The segment informs the client that the server still expects byte 601. But the server window size has expanded to 600. We need to mention that the sending of these segments depends on the policy imposed by the implementation. Some implementations may not allow advertisements of the receive window at this time. The server then needs to receive some data before doing so. After this segment arrives at the client opens its window by 200 bytes without closing it. The result is that its window size increases to 600 bytes. In this way, flow control is carried out by the transmission control protocol. I hope you understand it. In the next video, we will understand something more about TCP. Till then, bye-bye. If you like this video, press like and subscribe the channel and share the video. And don't forget to press the bell icon for my new video notifications. Thanks for watching.